As part of our continuing series, Their Lives Around Despite Incredible Odds, we have the story of a dreamer who wanted fame and fortune, was willing to work for it, got it, complete with a pop star boyfriend. It was the Hollywood high life, literally. Her friends envied her, but never knew the price she paid. At one point, she actually was living in a cardboard box. Years later, those same friends brought her back from the brink.
I always watch after you, don't I?
There was a time when June Fairchild, movie star, had one friend, an alley cat. Homeless, on the street, it was hard to remember being a golden girl, the high school prom queen.
I wanted to be a very popular girl in school, and I worked hard for that.
After graduation, when she was go-go dancing on TV, her high school friends watched in awe.
And I thought, boy, she's having a lot of fun. She looks like she's just really in her element here.
She's just on this adventure, this odyssey.
She's a great dancer, very charming. We lived together 5 years.
June met musician Danny Hutton while dancing and helped name his band after reading about Australian Aborigines who cuddle with their dogs on cold nights.
I came up with the name Three Dog Night.
Three Dog Night became a rock and roll legend in the 60s and 70s. They're still performing today. June back then was along for the intoxicating ride. She even appeared on one of their albums. That's her on the operating table wearing a mask, always in the middle of the action, until the action broke her.
I didn't like drugs, but I had to learn to like them. Isn't that awful?
It is. I mean,
it's
why?
Ridiculous.
Why did you make yourself like drugs?
Because I loved him so.
I didn't get into heroin or any of that kind of stuff, but pills, drinking, cocaine.
So I joined in. It was very hard on me.
June was hooked on drugs, alcohol, and show business. At first, it didn't slow her down. She landed movie roles with Clint Eastwood and Rock Hudson.
Oh, where have you been all my life?
In a Cheech and Chong movie, Up in Smoke, she played a hard partier, the Ajax lady. At the age of just 32, this was her 16th movie. Her old friends assumed June and her glamorous life didn't need them anymore.
I just figured she was living a Hollywood life and she was sort of off doing her own thing and wasn't really interested in reconnecting with her high school days.
Little did they know they were the only thing standing between June and destruction. She broke up with Danny Hutton and suffered through what she called two abusive marriages. Drugs pulled her down. With no more roles, she escaped to homeless shelters and seedy apartments in bad neighborhoods. Her glamorous life was over.
I felt like an angel in the middle of a snake pit down there. Because it's treacherous. The people, there's mentally ill, there's drug addicts, there's desperation.
You have a teenage daughter?
Uh-huh.
Did she know that you were homeless at one point?
Of course. I always kept in touch and let her know exactly what I was doing. Now mom's in a shelter. Don't worry.
But she didn't tell her daughter about the time she was raped. She did talk about her 44 days in jail for intoxication, about the nights she slept in a box on the street.
I thought maybe someone would try to come in the box and get me.
No one ever came to get June Fairchild. She thought she had no friends except a stray cat. This is where fate plays a hand. Her friends from high school were trying to track her down for a class reunion.
We got an address for her.
I was shocked.
She just was totally incoherent.
We'd mentioned names from the past. She didn't remember any of the names.
I just burst into tears.
I sent out email to all of our class, the people who knew her and everything.
June's high school friends showered her with money and letters of support. It gave her the courage to try again. What are you doing now? What have you done to turn your life around?
Quit drinking and stay busy, back to acting. I'll always keep coming back one way or another. But this time I'm going to stay.
June Fairchild, a story for our Recovery 101. When we